Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Mike, and this is a Nuka-Cola. In Fallout, Nuka-Cola is a unique soft drink that gained widespread popularity sometime before the Great War. It comes in a few flavors like Original Nuka-Cola, Nuka-Cola Cherry, and Quantum. Nuka-Cola Quantum was advertised as having twice the calories, carbohydrates, and caffeine of the original, with an extra kick being a mild radioactive strontium-90 isotope. So what if Nuka-Cola was real? To get a better idea of what's in Nuka-Cola Quantum, let's first take a look at what's in the regular, original Nuka-Cola. Taking a look at the label, it's pretty clear that the original Nuka-Cola has the same basic nutritional makeup of something like Coke or Pepsi. This trend continues down to the basic ingredients as well. So far, Nuka-Cola in the game should have the same flavor and nutritional value as any other cola drink in the real world. But to go from original Nuka-Cola to Quantum, it reportedly contains a mild radioactive strontium solution. Strontium-90 is a synthetically derived radioactive element present in radioactive fallout. Unfortunately, there's no indication that radioactive strontium would glow blue in water. Not only that, this metal is incredibly toxic, as it displaces calcium and primarily targets bone health. This only intensifies as the strontium you're replacing your calcium with is also radioactive. According to the FDA, they do test food that originates from places with nuclear fallout or nuclear leakages, such as Japan. However, the FDA has approved radiation techniques to kill bacteria and bugs in food with the use of gamma rays and even x-rays. What if Nuka-Cola Quantum didn't include radioactive isotopes at all? What if it was a marketing tool during the nuclear revolution? They may have used the FDA-approved irradiation techniques to ensure sterilization, but they probably didn't intentionally pollute the beverage. It's a much better guess to assume that the blue glowing attribute of Quantum doesn't come from a toxic strontium-90 radioactive particle. Unfortunately, the only Nuka-Cola Quantum that can be tested in Fallout 4 is about 200 years old. After that amount of time, less than 1% of the original strontium-90 would be left due to its 28-year half-life. Still, with that said, Nuka-Cola and Nuka-Cola Quantum both deliver the same amount of radiation to the consumer, 5 rads. Therefore, there's no indication that Quantum ever contained strontium-90. Assuming the body absorbed the energy evenly, one bottle of Nuka-Cola is enough to put you over your yearly recommended dosage, drastically increasing your chance of cancer and infection. Without care and within rapid succession, you'd only need to consume between 40 and 50 bottles to effectively destroy your DNA at the atomic level. Basically, you're going to die. For more on radiation, be sure to check out this video where I go into all kinds of details of nuclear fallout. If it isn't strontium-90 that makes Quantum glow, then what else could it be? A big indicator is the color. Most bioluminescent plants and animals do glow blue, just like Nuka-Cola Quantum, though most bioluminescent organisms are at least minimally toxic to humans, but not all are. In Seattle, people were reporting that their shrimp, fish, and crabs were glowing blue when left in the refrigerator or when the lights turned off. When questioned, the FDA reported that no scientific studies on the consumption of bioluminescent bacteria was done in almost 2 decades. Nobody reportedly got ill from eating the glowing seafood, but some reported nausea that may have been derived from the glowing bacteria. There's a pretty good rule of thumb out there. If your food is glowing, you probably shouldn't eat it. Put simply, there are less edible glowing objects than there are edible ones. Whether it be glowing mushrooms, poisonous bacteria, or toxic chemicals, there are a lot better ways to get the appearance of glowing food and beverages than eating toxic material and probably dying. Anyways, guys, it's been Mike with ShoddyCast. Be sure to subscribe to this channel as well as following the link down in the description to my channel for more great videos. If you want to see me more often on this channel, be sure to let them know in the comments down below. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching.